Chalo, hold each other's hands. Now slowly close your eyes. Okay. And I would request you all that as I speak, you start thinking about those things. But even if you don't, I'm pretty much sure that once I start talking about those things, you will have a lot of flashbacks coming in. Going back to August 14, you guys arrive in Manali. I still remember at 6:30, I was woken up by the call of Russell. And the first thing I was like, oh my God, 6:30 and they've started coming. I was very nervous because this was my first team after a break of 4 to 5 months. And slowly and eventually everyone came. I still remember Prashant was the first one when he came and he was like, mere shoes ke saath na mere ko ek rain cover mila hai. And I looked at the rain cover and I was like, okay, let's see if we can rent shoes. And we start our safety checking. Everyone slowly comes in with the documents. I speak to everyone. And from there onwards, I knew that, okay, fine, this is now going to be the family for 6 months. Now we are going to be a family and we are going to do this trek as a team. Of course, there were 20 of us. Now there are 17 of us. And the first day we start walking, we reach the Jogra roadhead. We have chai. We like stand in the rain waiting for the traffic jam to clear. And then slowly and eventually we start moving and we reach our first campsite, Jogra. I still remember Hinal coming into me, tents ki confusion ho rahi hai bahut zyada. And eventually the tents were sorted out. We sit in the dining and then we have our first snacks of the trek. I still remember the amazing smiles on people's faces when they saw the snacks. And Jogra it was. Uske baad mein, I guess Jogra raat mein a few people heard the voices of Arohi shouting moks, moks, moks. And the issue was sorted. So after that, it's our second day. We move from Jogra to Jwara. Full on rain. People say it rains cats and dogs. I'll say it rained cats, dogs, bulls, leopards, cheetahs, everything. And eventually we reached a point where we had to cross the Jwara Nala. And our technical guide comes in, Aditya. He fixes the rope. And apparently when the rope was fixed, I was finding my team so that we could cross, but the team was nowhere in sight. So I had to run back and call everyone. And eventually, one thing that I guess all of us learned that day was to face our fears. No matter how gushing the river was or how strong the current was, whatever it was, we made sure that we were working as a team. We crossed the whole stream as a team and then walked and moved forward from that stream again as a team. And then we reach our campsite. The most beautiful campsite of Hampta Pass, Jwara. Where it was so muddy that when people were keeping their slippers, only the foot was coming out, the slipper was coming along. And the snacks were served. I was in the kitchen having a discussion with the kitchen team when I swiftly heard someone shout, Narendra Bhaiya. And then it turned a little louder to Shyam Bhaiya, and then very louder to Moksh. And I ran outside the kitchen to see what had happened, to find a beautiful black inside the dining room. And I still remember Arshina standing there. She's like, "Isko bahar nikalo." And my first instinct was, "Arshina, I'm not a mule man. I'm a trek leader." But slowly, we got rid of that goat. Along with 3 tiffins. Just where the goat had peed. I still can't believe we literally like kurbani de diya. We just sacrificed those 3 tiffins instead of washing them. And when everyone had to go to sleep, I clearly remember the hope in everyone's eyes. Please God, please. We don't want it to rain. An amazing thing that happened. Ananthu is not feeling well that day. Some problem with the stomach. And Deepak, he comes to me and he's like, man, I am just constipated. And apparently Soumya also had the same problem, but eventually Soumya started feeling well, so Deepak kind of felt a little low. That was constipated. The third day comes, we move from Jwara to Baluka Ghera. The weather, oh my God, what a weather it was. It was not sunny, but it was also not rainy. The perfect weather we could have asked for. And then we slowly move. We do the direct from stream activity wherein all of us drank water like animals, just like it should be done in the wilderness. I'm pretty much sure that we all of us must have felt really fresh after drinking that water, because at least four of the team members came to me to tell that. And of course, not to forget Deepak again in the water for I don't know how many times. He probably drank 1 liter of water for that. And the push-ups, which I eventually lost. I hate you, Shivan. And from there onwards, we move. Now we reach the dhaba, where we have chai. And sitting inside the dhaba tent, I was just looking at every single one of you outside and how you were talking and having conversations, and I knew that, okay, fine. You know, it's very easy to say that we are a team, but it's very hard to actually work and actually behave as a team, which all of us have done on this trip. And I'm very glad, I'm very happy to say that I'm actually proud of every single person on this team. I know we are holding hands, but just know that in my heart, I'm clapping for you very loudly. And eventually we start walking towards Paluka Kera. Now we reach a point wherein all of us gather and we have small conversations about how mountains have changed us or what mountains have given to us. And from there we reduced some of our baggage. We told our stories to the rocks. And whatever it was, we gave that all away to the mountains and threw those rocks back into the wilderness, into the mountains, giving away all the negativity we had, making way for all the positivity. The mountains are going to give us. And we reached Paluka Kera, the amazing campsite. We had sun, we had clear weather. And I kind of fell asleep. And the moment I woke up, I still remember Rahul, Vandrila, Soumya, and some other people waiting with their phones to capture the clouds coming in. And the funny thing that happened was, they waited for a long time, but the clouds did not come. But when the batteries of their phones and cameras died, the clouds came in. So that was one thing. And then all of us as a team again, we went to see the sunset, where we clicked a lot of pictures. And we saw the sunset, a really big proof that even endings can be beautiful. Just like this ending of a trek is going to be beautiful, because now we have a lot of other people in our lives, a lot of new friends, a lot of new relations. But more than anything, a lot of new memories and a lot of new learnings the mountains have given. Paluka Kera, the day arrives for the summit briefing, when we talk about how the summit is going to be, what to expect, what not to expect, that hope in every one of us, that fear in every one of us, how things are going to be, kya hoga, kya nahi hoga. And eventually we start our day towards Hampta Pass. The weather was clear and we had some really good time climbing up the mountain. The speed was amazing. Everything was going our way, and eventually the mountains and the weather gods had something else in store for us. Maybe just to tell us that no matter how much we plan, sometimes it's just good to leave things to the energies around us. It's always amazing. It's always great to have a plan so that when things don't go your way, you have something to fall back upon. But just like it said, mountains have their own weathers. And not to forget, we all were able to cross the pass successfully and safely and reach Shia Guru, just because we actually proved that we are it was worth for the mountains to choose us instead of any other person. And I'm pretty much sure that after going back from this trek, apart from the salutations like Mr. or Mrs., you can proudly put Mount behind your name, because yes, if you have not conquered the mountain, which you can never do, you've conquered yourself on this trek. Maybe it's a physical fear, maybe it's a mental block, or whatever it is, we all have overcome a lot on this trek. And we reach here. I can still remember two or three people running up to me and they're like, Moksh, this campsite is on a plain ground. And it's like, yeah, I know that. That's very strange, because we haven't seen plain ground since a long time. And we reached Shia Guru, the amazing windy campsite. Jaha pe Arshina made a lot of walking reels, which right now a couple of us saw. Hum log baaki ko bhi for sure dikhayenge, because they're amazing. And Shia Guru, it was the amazing thukpa we had and the amazing masalas in it. Everything. And towards evening, I was in the kitchen again, and I again heard a lot of shouts and a lot of laughter. And for once, I got scared, because beech mein the voices got so loud, I thought, okay, fine, lad bade sab log. I literally ran bare feet inside the dining to see if everyone was fighting, to only find people playing dhamsharas. Okay, that's how it is. But again, looking at all of you right then, I knew that, yeah, this is a team. Not just for the sake of it, but this is a team. An important thing, I forgot the amazing cake we ate in Paluka Kera. Thanks to Soumya and Anand. for getting married on such a perfect day that we could have a cake in Baluka Gera at such an high altitude. Shia Guru, it was evening time. We went for a small walk. There, I had to prove that I'm a full-time employee and not a freelancer. But yeah, jokes apart, we saw a lot of peaks from there. A lot of amazing conversations which happened. A lot of virgin mountains which are already named without even being climbed. Be it Mount Srivastava, Mount SS, Mount S2. We had our own bit of fun and we come back to the campsite. A special shout out to Ananthu here, who despite being under fever, pushed on a lot on the past day as well and even today. Really big shout out. And to everyone else who was actually taking out time to ask me how Ananthu is doing, which clearly showed that every one of us lived up to our promise of taking care of each other. And from Shia Guru, we come to Chitra Chatru. We had to cross the Nashia Nala. And I am very sorry for the amazing losses that you've had to take in the way of your slippers. People wearing Crocs. It's amazing, you just had to turn on your sports mode and you are ready to go. And from Chatru, we start our journey. From Shia Guru, we start our journey towards Chatru. Not to forget the amazing lunch we had while coming to Chatru on a trail in the rain. And today, the amazing day when we had sun, as if the mountains were just trying to say a thank you to all of us for doing all the amazing work. And in the end, they blessed us with such an amazing weather, such beautiful sun, to say that, okay, fine, you've had a lot in the past few days and now it's your time to enjoy this amazing time, this amazing beauty, because you all deserve it. And from Shia Guru, we come to Chatru, slowly and slowly making our way, collecting tons of waste on the way, which I'm really proud of every single one. And believe me, these mountains, looking at all of you doing what you did, they are going to be really happy that they chose you. And I hope from the deepest part of my heart that you keep on getting chosen to be in the mountains again and again, trek to see the amazing beauty that they have to offer, to take all the positivity, and more than anything, talk to yourself and talk to the mountains. Because when the mountains talk, you can't hear anything. And I hope that on this trek in the past 6 days, the mountains did talk to you. And slowly we come to Chatru, the amazing cricket game, three best of three, and the amazing trophies, the amazing videos, the amazing things done for just for taking feel of being an actual cricket stadium. And from there onwards, we move on to pasta. I can never forget the reactions I got when people saw momos in Baluka Gera and I saw pasta in Chatru. Oh my God, this is like something else only. Probably Christopher Columbus after finding whatever. But yeah, we had snacks, we did the rentals and the group picture, the amazing group picture of graduating Hampta Pass. And then we slowly come inside the dining tent for our debriefing, which was started by an amazing remark from Heenan, saying that photo mein wo kala wala scary kutta bhi aa gaya. Yeah, this was our journey till now. Here you are right now, closing your eyes, with your eyes closed actually, holding each other's hands, going through the journey that you've lived for the past 6 days. This was our Hampta Pass. This was our share of 6 days on this beautiful trek, where every single one of you, I hope, have grown in some way or the other. Please leave your hands and open your eyes slowly. This was Hampta Pass. So, you've done a really great thing, okay? Just know that Hampta Pass, it's not easy. You've done a really great thing. And I know every single one of us had a lot of challenges in our head. And I'm not talking about rain or weather or terrain or a scent or whatever. I'm talking about the challenges in our head that we brought back on, brought to this trek when we came back from home, or we came from home. Make sure, like, right now everyone is calm, they're in their zone. I did see a lot of people about to cry, about to break down, and it's okay, stay in that zone, because whatever you felt in the past 6 days, it's something that you don't feel regularly. It's very normal.